Welcome everyone. Today I will discuss multiple choice questions of the chapter Matrices. You know, CBSE will conduct MCQ type exam at the end of November or at the first week of December. So, to solve MCQ type questions, you should know the theory and results. It seems that MCQ type questions are very simple, but this is not the case. You should have clear concept about the chapter, then you will be able to solve MCQ type of questions. Today, I will solve some MCQ type questions of matrices. At first, I discuss symmetric and skew symmetric matrix. I have already given the theory in previous video. Now, try to recall. Symmetric matrix. A square matrix, try to recall, a square matrix is said to be symmetric if A equals to A transpose. This is symmetric definition. Symmetric matrix, A equals to A transpose. And if A equals to minus A transpose, then it is skew symmetric. You know, it is replaced by dash or bar also for transpose. Now, or you can write, if A equals to A transpose, then we can also write Aij equals to Aji. Aij equals to Aji. And in this case, Aij equals to minus Aji. So, regarding elements, you get this definition, Aij equals to Aji. For example, look, capital A equals to Aag, HBA, GFC. Then A12 equals to H equals to A21. Aij equals to this. So, A13 equals to A31, A23 equals to A32. This is regarding elements. We have already discussed in my previous class. And we have also proved every square matrix can be expressed as a sum of symmetric and skew symmetric matrix. And A plus A transpose, we have also proved A plus A transpose, it is symmetric. So try to recall, and A minus A transpose is skew symmetric. Is skew symmetric. We have already proved this theorem. So problem number one, if A is symmetric, then A plus A transpose is. There will be four alternatives. So suppose symmetric, skew symmetric, diagonal, scalar. So look, A plus A transpose is symmetric. A minus A transpose is skew symmetric. So we have already proved this result. You have to recall. Proof is also important for 1 marks or 2 marks problem. Then we have also proved if A and B are symmetric matrix, then AB plus BA, AB plus BA is symmetric. We have already proved. And AB minus BA is skew symmetric. It's skew symmetric. So you get proof from any standard book, and I have also given book to my class of symmetric and skew symmetric matrices. So problem number 3, A and B are symmetric matrix, then AB plus BA is symmetric and AB minus BA, this is skew symmetric. So from theory you can take the right answer. Now listen, next problem number 5, the inverse of symmetric matrix is what? Inverse of symmetric matrix, so A is any symmetric matrix, therefore A equals to A transpose. A is symmetric. Now what is inverse of symmetric matrix? So A is symmetric matrix, so what is A inverse? It is symmetric or skew symmetric or none. So A inverse. So we have to prove what is the, what will be A inverse. So let B equals to A inverse. So what is B transpose? A inverse then transpose. We know A inverse transpose equals to AT inverse. So this A inverse transpose equals to A transpose then inverse. Now what is A transpose? A transpose equals to A since it is symmetric. So A and inverse additive. Now what is A inverse? A inverse equals to B. So B transpose equals to B. So what is B? B is A inverse. Inverse of symmetric matrix is symmetric. Inverse of symmetric matrix is symmetric. So this is proof, you have to remember the results. Next, problem number 6, A is symmetric and n is natural number, then what is a to the power n? It is, option will be given, it is symmetric, skew symmetric, orthogonal, 4 alternatives are given. So A is symmetric. So problem number 6. A is symmetric. So A transpose equals to A. Now we have to verify A to the power n is symmetric or others. So A to the power n, suppose B equals to A to the power n, n is natural number. So you know it is A up to A, n times. How many times? N times. Positive integer, power of positive integer. Now if we take B transpose, then A total transpose. Now transpose of matrix, product of matrix is transpose in reverse order. So it is A transpose into A transpose into A transpose, A transpose, A transpose, A transpose. In reverse order, mind it, AB transpose, B transpose into A transpose. Here all the matrices are A. That is why this one. Now this is A. A transpose equals to A. So this is A. This is A. 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 How many times? N times. A to the power n equals to b. So b transpose equals to b. So b is symmetric. B is symmetric. So what is b? A to the power n. So if A is symmetric, then A to the power n is also symmetric. Is also symmetric matrix. Now, similar like problem, problem number 7. A is skew symmetric matrix and n is a positive integer. Then a to the power n is symmetric, skew symmetric, diagonal, none. Diagonal and none. So exactly same, this is 7. A is symmetric, a transpose equals to minus a. Now b equals to a to the power n. So what is b transpose? Then a transpose, a transpose, a transpose, a transpose. Up to this is okay. Now what is a transpose? This is minus a. This is minus a. This one is minus a. Minus a, minus a, minus a. How many times? N times. So minus of 1 to the power n into a to the power n. Now look, this is our result. So if n is even, so this is a to the power n equals to b. It is n is even. And if n is odd, minus a to the power n equals to minus b, n is odd. So b to the power t equals to b, n is even. So it is symmetric. And if n is odd, it is skew symmetric. Is skew symmetric because you are getting minus b. So listen again, b equals to a to the power n, a n times. So b transpose in reverse order, a is skew symmetric, a is skew symmetric. So we are getting this. So now n is positive integer, so it may be symmetric or skew symmetric. If n is even, positive, then it is symmetric. Odd positive, then it is skew symmetric. So it is not mentioned n is even positive or not. If n is even positive, then symmetric. Odd, then skew symmetric. So answer will be none, because here it is not given. N is even or odd. Now problem number 8. A is skew symmetric matrix and n is even positive number. Then what is a to the power n? It is symmetric, skew symmetric, diagonal, none. So look, obviously n is even. N is even. So a to the power n is symmetric. A to the power n is symmetric. So you remember the result. Now, problem number 9. A is symmetric matrix, then A into A transpose is. So actually, if it is MCQ problem, then 4 alternatives will be given. So A into A transpose is phase matrix. A is symmetric matrix. A is square matrix. A is square matrix. Then A into A transpose is dash matrix. Fill up the gaps. So A into A transpose. Suppose B equals to A into A transpose. Then what is B transpose? A transpose, then total transpose. So it is product of transpose. So in reverse order. So this is A, transpose of transpose is original. So this is B. So B is symmetric. Very, very simple. This is symmetric. Symmetric. Suppose 4 alternatives are given, so you have to take only one. Now, theorem we have already proved this theorem. The diagonal elements of skew symmetric matrix are all zero. Most important theorem. The diagonal elements of skew symmetric matrix are all zero. We have already proved this theorem. So A is, look again, A equals to, what are the elements? Aij, n into n is skew symmetric. Therefore, Aij equals to minus Aji. You know alternative definition? Putting I equals to j. So Aii equals to minus Aii implies 2Aii equals to 0 implies Aii equals to 0. Aii equals to 0. That is A11 equals to A22, ANN equals to 0. So diagonal elements are all 0. This is important theorem for 2 marks. So diagonal elements are all 0. For second order, if we take second order matrix, so this is 0, this is 0. If it is A, it is minus A. So this is second order skew symmetric matrix. Now, a skew symmetric matrix of even order, so if you take it determinant A, so it will be minus A to 0. So this is A square. So if it is of even order, then it is a square number. So a skew symmetric determinants of even order A, then determinant A is a square number. If A is skew symmetric matrix of odd order, then determinant A equals to 0. So how? Look, determinant A, skew symmetric. So this is 0. If it is A, it is B. So this is 0, this is 0. We know diagonal. So if it is A, then it is minus A. If it is B, then it is minus B. If it is C, then it is minus C. So this is skew symmetric determinant. So if you take minus common property of determinant from each row, we are getting minus of 1 to the power 3. In case of determinant, if you have to take common from each element, minus common. So this is 0, this is minus A, this is minus B. 0, minus A, minus B. This is so first we change rows into columns. The value of determinant does not change if we interchange rows into columns. So first we change rows into columns. 0, minus A, minus B. A, 0, C. B, C, 0. Listen, we are changing rows into columns. No change of value. Then we are taking minus common from each row. So minus 1 to the power 3. So this will be 0, A, B. This is minus A, 0, minus A, 0. So A, 0, minus C. So A, 0, minus A, 0, C. So minus B, minus C, 0. Now this is minus 1 to the power 3. This is minus, and this is again determinant. So determinant A equals to minus determinant A. So 2 into determinant A equals to 0, determinant A equals to 0. Or this is general proof. Now properties of determinant, using properties of determinant, I have given the proof. So otherwise you take any, suppose this one, third order skew symmetric matrix, and if you expand, we get value as 0. So what is our trend? A skew symmetric matrix of odd order equals to 0. A skew symmetric matrix of odd order A, then determinant A equals to 0. This is general proof. So we are getting 9, 10 and 11. Now there is a problem also. Trace of skew symmetric matrix. 12. Trace of skew symmetric matrix. Is dash. So look, trace means sum of diagonal elements. So what is sum of diagonal elements? Sum of diagonal elements of skew symmetric matrix is 0. So answer is 0. So what is definition of trace? Sum of diagonal elements. For example, look, if we take any matrix, suppose A, B, C, D, E, A, G, H, I. So for square matrix, so what is trace? Trace equals to sum of diagonal elements. Always remember, this one is diagonal, I equals to J, this one is not diagonal. So A plus E plus G H I, so this is I. Sum of diagonal elements is trace of the matrix. So what is definition of trace? Sum of diagonal elements. So through this video, I have discussed some important and very simple problem of determinant, mainly symmetric and skew symmetric matrices. So these are most important problem for board. So in the next class, I will discuss some more problems of MCQ type problem of matrices. Thank you for today.